is a result of vision. We've been talking about life vision. Once again, we'll read the scripture in Proverbs that talks about vision. Proverbs 29:18, which says that where there is no vision, the people are unrestrained, but happy is he who keeps the law. So vision is very important. And we talked a little bit about this the last time when we said that with vision, we identify our purpose. We know the direction in which we've got to move. Now, a few more things about having a vision. Now, vision really helps us to choose our battles. Imagine when Joshua and his people went to possess the promised land, if they didn't know what they needed to do, if they didn't know that they needed to bring down the wall of Jericho, what would have happened? You know, Joshua would not know what to instruct the people, and there would just be no sense of purpose among them. If we do not know what it is that we've got to do, what begins to happen is that we put our energy in every battle, and we are unable to choose the right battles in our lives. So a vision is going to help us choose our battles so that we can move ahead to possess the promises of God that have been given to us. Vision will help us to avoid crooked paths, detours that we may end up taking. There are many temptations. There are several options out there, and each one could be doing just about anything. But what is it that we are called to do? When we get a vision from God and we are clear that, God, this is what you want me to do. God, I believe that you want me to share your word. Or God, I believe that you've called me for the upliftment of the poor. Or if you know that God has called you to take the gospel to certain nations, then you're putting all your energy into that and you're moving in that direction, and you realize that whatever God has called you to do, you're able to do it well. So distractions can be avoided when we have a strong vision. A vision will move us in the direction that God wants us to move in. As we invest time and energy in the direction where God is calling us, we know that in our lives, we've got to invest in skills. We've got to invest in upgrading ourselves. We've got to invest in equipping ourselves to accomplish all that God wants us to accomplish. And so when we are clear about certain things that God is calling us to do, we can intentionally set aside time, and we can intentionally make connections. We can intentionally invest in those skills and in those talents. And we realize that as we do that, we are increasing in our capacity. We are doing much more than what we were able to do earlier. And what we're creating is that we are creating value in the direction where God is calling us to use our energies. So a vision is very important. It's going to keep us focused. It's going to help us choose our battles. It's going to prevent distractions in our lives. And a vision is going to help us develop ourselves to accomplish the purpose of God for us. Shall we pray together? Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, that, Lord, you have called each one of us, oh God, Lord, to fulfill your purpose for our lives. And God, we pray that God, any distraction, Father God, that we have, that it'll be removed in the name of Jesus. That, Father, Lord, even through your word and God, through, Lord, the many experiences that you bring our way, Father, that you will show us, God, the direction that you have chosen for us. And God, we just give ourselves fully to your purpose. And Father, I pray that each one will excel, oh God, in what you have called them to do. And God, let every person, oh God, glorify your name. We thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.